Hey guys, I'm gonna show you how you can run your teacher reports in TypeToLearn. So first, log into the program, and then over here on the left, you'll have a button that says Student Reports. You're gonna click on that. There's two different reports that we can run. So the first report I'm gonna show you is click on this drop-down box. We're gonna choose the status report. So when you click on that, this screen pops up. You can change your date range. So if you wanted to have an idea of what students were doing in a specific date range, you could come in here and select the range that you wanted to look at. So I'm just going to look at January. Under the group, if I change that to my class, then I'll only see my class's results. One thing to point out is right here that all you're seeing in this screen is students who have completed the final challenge. And these are the numbers that will show up on the school report. So as kids complete final challenges, that's what's showing that they're active in the program. So I'm going to click Generate Report, and then it's going to take just a couple of seconds. It'll pull your report for you, and you're gonna see that some of your kids are kinda all over the place depending on where they're at and when they have started. So if I look at some of these, what you're looking at is how they're doing in each of their lessons. So this shows that they've completed the final challenge in lesson 16, 17, 18, 19. You have two numbers in each box. The top number is the words per minute, which is that is not what we're concerned about. It's the bottom number that we're concerned about, which is their accuracy. This happens to be a fourth grade class, so you can see their accuracy is at 75%. If they meet the words per minute and the accuracy goals, then their box is green. If by chance they only meet one of those goals, then their box is yellow. So you can kind of look through here to see how your students are doing in the program. I see that these couple of kids, they have one more lesson and an assessment, and then they would be done with the first level. So that's the first kind of report, is a status report. And again, that is only final challenges. Now, if you know that your students have been working in TypeToLearn, but they're not showing up in here, that's when we want to go look at our detailed report. So I'm going to come up here to this drop-down. I'm going to select detailed report. I'm going to click generate report. I'm actually going to make sure my dates are January only. And then I'm going to click generate report. And what this is going to do is every time the student logs in to TypeToLearn, it's going to show you what they are working on. Now, you can filter students by just typing in some characters up here at the top, or you can also click on these headings and you can sort. So if I wanted to sort by date to see what all my students were doing by the last time we went to the computer lab, now I have the date and then I can see what each of them were doing. So it'll tell you right here what the activity or what the lesson was, and then it will show you what activity they were working on. So this person did a lesson, a final challenge, this person another lesson, this person did a lesson, a final challenge, a lesson. So you can kind of see that some of these students are not doing any of the games. So this one, they've done some games, but you can kind of see if they are in the program, but they're not advancing, you can come in here to see exactly what it is that they're doing. So I hope that helps a little bit with you kind of having an idea of what your students are doing. So I would log in periodically, maybe like once a week or once every 2 weeks, and just kind of check it out and kind of see where they're at. Thank you guys.